Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys Multicam Smart Switcher, a new feature in Resolve 20. This is available on the free and the studio version, so let's check it out. Here I got two clips, an A cam and a B cam. I'm going to make a multicam clip out of that. How you do that is highlight the clips you want to select, right click, and the second option is create new multicam clip using selected clips. This will give you a chance to name it. I'll just name it Multi. I'm going to leave everything alone as far as frame rate. We want it to sync with the sound. I'm going to use source audio channels. I deselected the move source clips to original clips bin. Normally just put it in a folder. We'll hit create and it'll sync these two clips up. You can think of this as a mini timeline. So here's our new clip right here, and it's called Multi. And if we hover over it and play.
Over the last 10 years.
We can see it's in sync, but if you want to check the sync, you can right click and say open in timeline. And if you have a slate or sync marker, we can see here both the A or both angles, A and B cam, are in sync. And if you want to do a few other things like tidy up, maybe trim it to here so all the tracks are trimmed, you could delete your tracks there and maybe make them both in sync here and just get everything tidy. You can do that. And then you can close this timeline down. Then you grab your multicam clip and actually put it on a regular timeline. So now it's showing multicam angle one with multicam audio. Now here is the great thing. Right click. Down below here, we now have multicam smart switch. Let's click it. We get this dialog box. You can change things like the minimum edit duration and edit delay. And if you want to favor one of the angles, if one of your angles is a wide angle and you want to refer back to that more often, you can. And then with this box deselected, you could say, how do you want it to switch? There's a faster and a better quality setup. And then there's a use audio only for fast analysis. That's what we're going to do here. So it's going to listen to the speaker and kind of try to determine the cuts where the dialogue changes. It doesn't take very long. This is a short clip, but now we have a cut up timeline.
Do you know what this means?
So let's check out what it did if we go back to the start here.
Portrait ad number 6.
I'll teach you how to paint like this in just a few hours.
I'll teach you.
All right, so right there, it did a little bit of a late cut. Here's the beauty. If you click right here in between your two cuts, you'll get this little bracket icon. Just click right in the middle of the cut on the A and the B side. You can see both sides of the clip turn green. You can use your period and comma keys to trim where this edit begins and ends. So it leaves the cut, it just moves it over. Then hit shift back arrow and you can review that edit.
I'll teach you how to paint like this in just a few hours.
Can we actually do it? Now if you want to cut the next one, just hit the down arrow and trim that one. Next one, trim that one. So you can see you could fly through these edits really quickly. And if you need to trim some of the dead space, you can still park your playhead and hit trim to playhead if you have that as a shortcut. It's very easy to work with. So here's an edit we might want to trim. Same thing, just trim it over, review it.
Sign up.
I'm an artist since I was 15.
My name is Dimitri Milan and I've...
So pretty easy. That's the new smart switcher. This thing's going to save you a lot of time, especially for the podcast editors out there or anything with a couple of different camera angles. You have to sync it still as a multi-camera clip, but after that, this thing will kind of give you a rough cut almost instantaneously. Very cool. All right, thanks for watching. Leave a comment down below if you got a topic you want me to make a video on, and I'll see you guys on the next video.